was by accident or on purpose, but nonetheless, it brought the Trooper right into contact with the ring post.
Well, the Trooper, being a former football player, was coming in with that big shoulder to try to finish off WT, and WT made some quick thinking getting out of the way, and now the Trooper, for the first time in a long time, really in trouble.
Well, WT is a big
guy.
Look at that. Bench pressed him right out of there. Strength, power, and finesse. The Trooper's got it all.
Yeah.
Now he is giving it all to W.T. Jones.
You just look at the expression on the Trooper's face. That's how you can tell that an athlete is ready to play. And this guy is ready. He's pumped up. You can see that expression. The adrenaline is pumping. Beautiful drop kick.
He got up high and got it right on the point of the chin of W.T. Jones.
He's got his momentum going now, Ralph. I don't think WT can stop him unless he comes up with a big defensive move right here.
Great train running downhill. Here he comes to lock in a big pitch. Once this is on, it's just a matter of seconds before WT is yesterday's due.
He's trying to fight it, trying to pull the big grip of the Trooper off, but there's no way. I have never seen anybody get out of this hold. The Trooper calls the pinch.
And you and I have talked about this, much like the Sleeper, when a guy tries to fight it, that pisses his head off, and then he's even worse off.
Right? He's history, and right there you have it. One of the finest athletes in professional wrestling today, the Trooper, your winner over W.T. Jones.
Out comes the citation pad, letting them know who it was that did the damage when W.T. finally comes to.
You know, one thing I said earlier, Ralph, is what I like about the Trooper is he focuses on his competition. And he really focused on WT. Even though he made one big mistake in that match, he really fired back and came back on it. His whole team, Baron Spencer's, is fired up now. The countdown to the finals in the Team Challenge Series is coming up, and they say they're going to walk away with it. And right now, I can hardly see anybody catching Baron Spencer.
Today's Team Challenge Series main event features Hangman Killer against Tommy Jammer.
And that'll be Larry Zbyszko's team represented by the Hangman, and Baron Spitzer's being represented by Tommy Jammer. So that one's coming up later in the weeks to come. Behind the eight ball. Everybody's behind the eight ball right now, Ralph. Sarge's Snipers and Larry's Legends have got to gain points on Baron Spitzer's. They're going to have the opportunity in the weeks to come.
Look at the strength and power of the Trooper locking in the big pitch. W.T. Jones at that point is just a memory as the Trooper takes
and
it to
the lights, party's room.
I've heard that song.
Oh, my old buddy, Danny Dine, used to sing that.
Dan DeRue, number 11 for the Dallas Cowboys. Right there, W.T. can't read any numbers. Let's go to Eric Bischoff. He's standing by with more.
Ralph and Greg, whether it's the playoffs in the NFL or the final game in the World Series in Major League Baseball or the last hole at the U.S. Open, the level of enthusiasm, the excitement, the adrenaline that makes professional athletes stand out among everyone else reaches a level that, well, it makes us all excited. We all want to watch and see it. At this point, I want to bring in the World Tag Team Champion Destruction Crew. I want to talk about, well, next week begins the countdown, the finals of the Team Challenge Series, and I've never seen any professional wrestlers so psyched up as I am right now going into the finals. Me and Mike, I want to ask you, if that's okay, Wayne the Train, what your team is doing. What's Larry's Legends doing to prepare for this final stretch?
It's motivation.
Hold on, Mike, I'll handle this one. You see, Bischoff, I can tell you never really competed in nothing in your life. You're just a dweeb. You're just a dweeb. You come out here and you talk about everybody being all pumped up. You see, but a real champion has to stay cool, calm, and collected until that day. You got to keep your thoughts. You got to keep your head. You got to know what's going on in that ring at all times. And everybody's all pumped up. Everybody's all jacked up, higher than the sky, getting all excited for the big day. The big day, who's going to win that $1 million? You see, we know deep down that Larry's Legends is going to come out the victor. We don't have a problem with that. We know, because when that final day comes...
How do we know, Wayne?
Hold on, Mike. I'll handle this. We know because we're the best. The best always end up beating the best. And when that bell goes off, there's also a bell that goes off inside my head. And you see, when my head starts ringing, I start thinking, who can I beat up next? Who's going to get in my way? Who's the marked man? Anybody steps in the ring with the Destruction Crew, and they're going to pay for it one way or another. Maybe a part of their body is going to come off.
star wrestling ringside, Ralph Craig Gagne, and that man, Larry Zbyszko, the living legend from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the former Nittany Lion. Again, I'll say it. If it's the truth, it ain't bragging. This guy likes to put his money where his mouth is, and he is truly the undefeated, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world.
Well, he definitely is, and his fans here, this capacity crowd on hand tonight, is letting Larry Zbyszko know what they think of him. They don't like him.
Well, they don't like him a whole lot, but, I mean, here's a guy that Greg isn't shy about going anywhere to defend his title. He is a true champion's champion in every sense of the word, and a lot of guys don't even get out of the U.S. This guy does.
Well, a lot of the champions from the other leagues do not. Larry Zbyszko has been all over the world. He's defended the title in Europe. He just came back from a recent tour of Guam and the Hawaiian Islands here in the United States. He'll be going to Australia and New Zealand to defend the world title. And there's rumors that he'll be wrestling in Moscow, Russia. They're trying to put together a match between Nikita Koloff and Larry Zbyszko to take place in Moscow. Wouldn't that be something? A first for American-style wrestling.
Probably stay at the Cosmos Hotel in beautiful downtown Moscow. Right next to St. Basil.
You been there?
Oh, yeah. Wonderful place. I'll tell you about the Sputnik Lounge someday. A lot of fun.
You're a Sputnik Lounge.
There is the living legend, Larry Zbyszko, against Tony Leone. From Hell's Kitchen, New York, there's a rumor going around that Tony used to pound the meat at the place he used to work, Mizuno's Meat. Sylvester Stallone happened by it a long time ago and got the idea and put that training sequence in his Rocky film.
Well, Stallone so far has had more success pounding that big side of beef than Tony Leone has had in his wrestling career. But today he's got an opportunity to upset the world heavyweight champion right here on TV, and Larry Zbyszko is a confident, sometimes overconfident wrestler. And if he's overconfident in this match, it could all backfire on him.
And his team has had some troubles lately, perhaps due to some of that overconfidence in the Team Challenge Series. Greg, we talked about his leadership ability in recent weeks, both he and Sergeant Slaughter's teams faltering just a bit. And we say that if you're going to put the blame on someone or you're going to take the credit, it's got to be the team leader. And the team leader of Larry's Legend is that man who just took a big hit from Tony Leone, Larry Zbyszko. What about that?
Well, you can take a look at professional football. The blame, 90% of the time, will go on the quarterback. He's supposed to be the leader out there. In the Team Challenge Series, your leader or your quarterback are the captains. Larry Zbyszko, Sergeant Slaughter, and Baron Blitzer, Baron von Raschke. And the Baron has really got his team motivated, and they've really come on strong the last few weeks and have taken a big lead over the Sergeant, over Larry's Legends. But coming up in the countdown to the finals in the weeks to come, everybody's behind the eight ball. And there's some big matches coming up. A lot of points at stake, so Zbyszko and Slaughter can get back into it. But they are going to have to unite their team. And as you said, Zbyszko hasn't been able to do that as of late.
I'll tell you what, Zabisco's got an opportunity to get a couple of points today, I really believe, as Hangman Killer goes against Tommy Jammer. And, oh, whoa! And Hangman Killer might do some of that to the young man Tommy Jammer today. Then our Team Challenge Series main event, giving Zbyszko an opportunity to get some points. And he is showing right now, Hangman Killer, that today he means business. Boom.
Boy, he just really suckered Leone into turning his back there. And when he did, he hit him with that big right. And that set Leone up for this. Right here, the Zbyszko pile driver. And that should be it for Mr. Tony Leone.
Larry Zbyszko's front pile drive.
Takes a lot of himself.
He surely does.
He's on a roll, but he's going to have to get his team motivated. And what he's going to have to do is get them together and unite and get back in the running for the $1 million in the Team Challenge Series. Here is the Zbyszko pile driver that finishes off Tony Leone.
As my colleague Eric Bischoff would say, I wonder what Zbyszko sees when he looks in the mirror. Let's go now to Eric.
Thank you, Ralph and Greg. And at this time, I'd like to bring in Baron von Raschke. He's leading in the Team Challenge Series. And Baron, I want to ask you, as a former national champion of your native country, you're a former world champion of professional wrestling, a lot of times going into the stretch, the finals of any sport, a team can get complacent. They can let their guard down. Is that going to happen to Baron's Blitzers?
Don't look complacent. There's my team, athletes like the Trooper, the Alaskans, DJ Peterson, Todd Becker. Do any of those look like they're complacent. They're working harder now than they've ever worked. You know, when you're in competition, and these men have always all their lives been in competitions, big competitions. You never let down, you never relax, you never take it easy, because you know your opponent's out there preparing. He's preparing, he's waiting for you to make one little slip. Do you think Joe Montana relaxed and took it easy before the Super Bowl? Do you think Larry Bird takes it easy before the NBA playoffs? Do you think any great athlete, Buster Douglas, was sleeping when he took Tyson down in Tokyo? Do you think any great athlete takes it easy? Barron's Blitzers are all great athletes. They're all prepared. They're all waiting, and they're all thinking like a team. It's teamwork. They know they rely on each other. They're pumping each other up, and we're coming after that championship prize. And that is all the people need. Complacent.
Welcome back to All-Star Wrestling. Coming up a bit later on, our Team Challenge Series main event, another good one. Hangman Killer from Larry's Legends against Tommy Jammer of Barron's Blitzers. But now to the ring for these announcements and our next match. The
following event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing currently in the ring from Junction City, Kansas, here is Spike Jones.
Has yet to get that title from Larry Zbyszko, and more importantly, maybe even to the Sergeant, he can't quite rally the troops to get going in the Team Challenge Series.
Well, I had the opportunity to talk to Sergeant before the match just tonight. He really seems down, and you know, this is not the time of the year to be down. They've only got a few weeks left in the Team Challenge Series for the $1 million. He's got to try to unite that team of his and get them back in the running. He's had a tough pull all year, though. Colonel DeBeers has been just hard man to deal with, caused a lot of dissension on the team, and now he's got Buck Zumoff in there as a wild card member, a great addition to his team. But Zumoff and Johnny Stewart don't see eye to eye, so there's a lot of dissension, and it's got that team really not in a good position, and they've fallen behind. They were picked at the beginning of the year to run away with it. They're behind Barron by quite a bit. They do have an opportunity in the next few weeks to get back in it, but the Sarge is going to have to get that drive, that desire that an athlete has inside, and get it, communicate with his team and get them back on track.
Well, he has no trouble communicating with the fans that come out to adore him. I mean, he really has great rapport. You would wonder why that doesn't carry over. And I mean, I guess it's just the personalities are clashing so much that,
you know, people react different to losses, Ralph, and that's any walk of life. Any setback, every individual reacts differently. And the Sarge, even though he's a veteran, he's a pro, and I've seen him come off of losses before and been fired up and go right back in there, it looks like he's lost a little bit of his edge. That loss to Zbyszko in Guam has really affected him. And maybe the pull all year with his team and the team challenges affected him. I don't know. But he's not the Sarge of old. Let's see what he can do today. See if he can get it together against his 283 pounds, Spike Jones.
He's taking on one big guy in Spike Jones. Let me ask you, Greg, what would you do if you know Sergeant Slaughter very well? What kinds of things would you do to get yourself back on track when you're in a slump? What do you do as a
man? Well, I'm a different type of professional than the Sarge is. I get fired up, well. I mean, any athlete, if you're a good one, you get more determination. You just say, hey, there's no way anybody can beat me, and I'm going to go back in the room, and I'm going to prove it not only to myself, but to the world that I am the better man. Right here with the Cobra Clutch, Sarge has proven he is the better man. And I haven't seen anybody get out of the Cobra clutch. Sarge should put Spike Jones out. There it is. Your winner. And maybe this is what he needed. A guy like Spike Jones to get him fired up. He's got to get that desire, that winning attitude that a successful athlete has.
He made short work of Spike Jones, and I'll tell you, as you mentioned, one of the ways to get back on track is to get that desire and that intensity, and he really channeled it and made himself quite a victory here. A pair of short clotheslines on Spike Jones. There's one right there.
Well, you can take an athlete like Joe Montana. When the big game is up, when the Super Bowl is at stake, he comes out. That's when he is at his best. And maybe that's why the Sarge is down. He wasn't at his best in Guam. Maybe he can get it back together. We're going to have to see in the weeks to come.
His business is done inside the ring, but now let's go to Sergeant Slaughter with more. Very inspirational delivery by Sergeant Slaughter, who has served notice. He is back. Let's go to Eric Bischoff. He's standing by with more.
Ralph and Greg, if I could think of one word that would sum up the change in personalities that I've seen going into the Team Challenge Series Finals, is attitude. And certainly the heavyweight champion of the world, known for his attitude. I've got to ask you, you're a portion of your team. We're talking about the World Tag Team Champion Destruction Crew. We're out here earlier. And certainly a whole new attitude on that team.
Well, I think you've noticed that Larry's legends are calm, are cool, and are collected. You know, I've heard rumors now, Sergeant Slaughter, he's got his team members running through the mud, dodging bullets, eating bugs. Meanwhile, Baron's Blitzers, him and his goofy ex-football players, are ramming their heads into the walls and smashing their bodies into the lockers. Meanwhile, Larry's legends, we have Big Mo. We have motivation. We have coolness. I transformed over into my team members. I'm talking about guys like the World Tag Team Champions, the Destruction Crew. Talking about guys like the Hangman. I've got a couple wild card surprises that I've got left to use in the next upcoming month, Bischoff.
Who are they?
I'm not going to tell you. All I want to say is, this is the attitude of Larry's legends. We know we are the winners. It's our fate. It is our destiny. As sure as I went to Tokyo, Japan, and sold $4 million worth of tickets to the biggest ripoff in history, I stayed calm and cool and collective, and I brought back the heavyweight championship of the world. I defeated San Martino, I retired Bockwinkel, and I've told my team how we're going to win it, and they believe me. And $1 million is going right to Larry Land.
They've got a good lead. They're going after the $1 million. Look at this team lineup. The Trooper, Candy Devine, ladies champion, Yukon John, the timekeeper, Mike George, Tommy Jammer, the Tokyo Bullets, Baron Von Raschke, the Russian Brute, Brad Ringens, Flapjack Norton, and DJ Peterson. What a lineup.
Wow.
No wonder they're in first. And on Zabisco's team, you have a lot of problem people, like Ken Patera. He doesn't get along with Zabisco. Coquina Maximus, we have not seen. Tully Blanchard, another problem. Sergeant Snipers, Colonel DeBeers, Johnny
problem.
Johnny
problem all the way down, Sergeant Slaughter's leg.
Really, without a doubt. Beautiful hip lock takedown by the Thumper, Frankie DeFalco. I'm surprised Frankie hasn't been picked up as a wild card member.
Big, mean, and mobile.
I mean, Jake Milliman, after all, he is the leading point getter for Larry's Legends.
Can you believe that? Can you believe that Jake Milliman, and especially with Larry Zbyszko and all his tactics to try and remove him from the team?
All the champions he has on his team and all he can think about is, how do I get Jake off of it?
The guy who's getting him the most points. Oh, great reversal by DJ, but a block by the Thumper DeFalco. DJ went inside, then up and over. Great takedown by DJ Peterson.
Beautiful takedown. You know, a new tag team formed here in the AWA, one that I am really looking forward to see, is DJ Peterson and the Trooper. And what a matchup against the Destruction Crew. That was one I wouldn't want to miss.
Oh, Frankie DeFalco, wish he'd have missed that one. DeFalco in some big-time hurt. I can't wait to see DJ Peterson and the Trooper wrestling. I mean, I am so excited about this combination. I think the two of them are really going to make some noise.
Well, we saw the Trooper earlier on in the program, a great single wrestler. DJ Peterson, a good single wrestler, but what a team they would make. Great bodies, great athletes, a lot of movement in the ring. They would give the crew all they could handle and a whole lot more.
And DJ, we have seen, gone sort of from partner to partner looking for the right combination. I have a feeling now that the chemistry could be very right for those two.
Oh, definitely would be, Ralph. And you can see the movement that DJ Peterson has in that ring. He came off that ropes and the whole ring shook. You could probably hear it there, parts of it falling apart. But he's got a lot of momentum going here today. He's really fired up into a short arm scissors, a hold you haven't seen in a long time. A lot of pressure on the wrist and elbow of Frankie DeFalco. Somehow he's going to have to get up on his feet just like that and get DJ in a pinning position.
Well, he's got him in a very compromising spot there, but it was Gary DeRuscia got him off of the ropes and favoring DJ Peterson.
This is a real wearing hold on an opponent. I mean, it is hard. It's tough to get out of. There's a lot of pain in the arm, and then you've got all the weight of your opponent that you have to try to get up. So there's a lot the guy down below has on him.
How do you get out of it, Greg? Any way to get out of it?
Oh, there is, but it's real tough. What I've seen a lot of guys do that are real strong is roll over on their back and up on their feet. And if you're strong enough, pick the man up on your shoulder and get yourself to the rope.
Well, he was able to escape and then get out of the way, and DJ Peterson took some kind of hit.
Those ropes really snapped the hamstrings of DJ Peterson. If I was DeFalco, I'd go down underneath. Oh, a beautiful power slam. Could be it.
Wrapping him up. Powerful kick out at two by DJ Peterson.
I would go after the hamstrings of DJ Peterson. That's where he was hurt. DeFalco making a mistake here.
Reversal by DJ straight into a backdrop, then following up. Picking him up for a body slam. Going for the cover. One, two. DeFalco kicks out at two, but very warily. Now DJ off of the rope. Ooh. Came face forward. One, two.
DeFalco's attention towards the crowd. I don't know if somebody at ringside bothered him or what. He looked away and caught a knee up under the chin.
And again, distracted or mistimed at any rate. That gives DJ Peterson a chance to lock in the Scorpion leg lock. And when he turns him over, that's it. It's all but timeout for Frankie the Thumper DeFalco. 1, 2, 3 and out. DJ Peterson is your winner. Let's go to Eric Bischoff. He's standing by with more.
All right, that was DJ Peterson in action, and certainly he and the rest of Baron's Blitzers enjoying their lead right now in the Team Challenge Series. In fact, to find out more on the series and the standings, let's go to Lee Marshall. He's standing by with an update.
Thanks very much. Hi again, everybody. Well, the Legends philosophy of the Big Mo, motivation, the one that's supposed to help them get back into the million-dollar race, I got a guarantee for you. It's not working. For 3 weeks now, Big Mo has been the talk amongst the Legends, but so far, it has produced zero results. Anticipation awaits as we wait to see if they continue to rely on this new method. Meanwhile, the Blitzers so far have been the only team that's been able to maintain any cohesiveness among its team members. They have made all the right moves, picking up wild card members that have been as unique as the matches they've competed in. Last week in the Team Challenge Series main event, it was the ladies who battled for the points. Candy Devine picked up another point for the Legends when Mimi unknowingly slingshot her over the top ropes. The points not only helped her team, but they also helped Candy's chances in the race for the most valuable wrestler of the Team Challenge Series. But she'll need to pick up 4 points and keep winning to catch up to the leader of the pack, the Trooper. Colonel DeBeers is currently in second place. Yukon John and Hangman Killer are tied at 9, while the early surprise of the season, Jake the Milkman Milliman, is in a 5-way tie for 5th. The remaining weeks in the Team Challenge Series gives us a chance to gain a whole lot of points, so the heat is on as both individuals and the team sweat it out in wrestling's hottest action. I'm Lee Marshall.
All right, Lee Marshall and wrestling fans, today's main event between Texas Hangman Killer and the California Kid Tommy Jammer certainly will have an impact on those standings. We're going to have that main event for you, as well as the illustrious one, Johnny Stewart. He's coming your way right after this break.
Welcome back to All-Star Wrestling. Coming up in just a few minutes, today's Team Challenge Series main event. From Larry's Legends, Hangman Killer. From Baron Blitzer's, Tommy Jammer. But now, to the ring for these announcements and our next match of the day.
The following wrestling event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing currently in the ring, from Longview, Texas, weighing in at 216 pounds, he is Jim Evans. And his opponent, making his way to the ring area, hails from the Pacific Palisades, California. Weighing in at 232 pounds, he is the illustrious Johnny Stewart.
Hear that song? That's Johnny Stewart. Yeah, man, he's moving, he's shaking. Look at that robe. I mean, is he a fashion statement or what?
Or what is what I think he is. Spoiled rotten is what he really is. I mean, he comes out here and talks about the new Porsche his dad bought him and all the nice clothes he's got, and that the $1 million in the $1 million Team Challenge Series doesn't mean that much to him. All he's concerned about is winning the light heavyweight title, which he is in contention for, a tournament going on around the country. Two leading contenders, this man, Johnny Stewart, and Rock and Roll Zumar. And they are both on Sarge's team, and that is one of the problems that Sarge has. Zumar continually calling Stewart Johnny Stu Rat, the Rat.
But Zumar definitely having opinions about this man, Johnny Stewart, who right now is going and taking quick work to Jim Evans. Boy, he is a tough one, though, Greg. When he gets in the ring, he certainly has the moves.
Well, he really does, Ralph. I mean, he can go when he wants to go. He likes to go with a rough style, and I don't particularly think he would have to do that. He's a much better wrestler than that. But apparently he doesn't believe in his wrestling ability that much to go out there and wrestle one-on-one with the man. He's got to resort to the rough tactics.
Flying elbow, body slam, and dropping the elbow. Look at the casual cover by Johnny Stewart.
Who does he think he is? I'm surprised at Jim Evans. Jim usually comes to the ring all fired up and ready to go, and he'll get on his opponent right away. Stewart has done a good scouting job on Evans. Knowing that, he got to Evans early.
Well, there's a chop by Stewart, countered by Evans, and now they get in a bit of a chop fest.
Whoa!
Look at Evans going to work on Johnny Stewart. Into the corner they go. Evans now with a brief flurry. Rolls Stewart into the corner, following up. Look out. Johnny Stewart got out of the way, and now he's working on that knee, Greg. He's twisting the brace.
Now the referee, Todd Becker, should check that knee right now. Stop the match. He turned that knee pad around, and then he hits Evans with it. Evans is down, and he's out for the three count.
One, two, three.
That. He doesn't need that, Ralph.
Well, he is going into the intimidation game, trying to send a message to any and all challengers, including Rock and Roll Man himself, Buck Zumoff. You saw the end of the way that he twisted that knee brace. Off of the ropes goes Jim Evans, and then waiting is that steel case knee of Johnny Stewart, dropping down for the cover. One, two, three, and he is history, man. That's it. Pump up the jams. You got it all day long. The illustrious Johnny Stewart is your winner. Let's go to Eric Bischoff. He's standing by with more.
Well, Ralph and Greg, you know, it's very interesting. At the beginning of the Team Challenge Series, Everybody was coming out talking about their strategies, how they were going to win the Team Challenge Series. Now there's a lot of secrecy in the camps, particularly in the camp of Sergeant Snipers. At this time, I'd like to bring in Buck, Rock and Roll Zuma.
Hey, hey. Well, let me tell you something. Isn't that something? It's $1 million. You'll be surprised what a guy can do with $1 million. And that's crazy Sergeant Slaughter. He's got us out there in the backwoods someplace, and we're going underneath this barbed wire fence, and we're crawling up these great big high pillars with these ropes hanging out. He thinks we're going back to Vietnam or something. And then we got this crazy, the Beers. And we got you, Rat. That's right, Johnny Stewart, the Rat. And he, but where are they? We're out there working out. We're out there doing push-ups. We're working together like a team for this $1 million. And now we're missing these two clowns. They're not out there working out. They're not out there doing push-ups. They're not out there ducking underneath them bullets flying through the air.
Is it, I mean, dissension's still a problem?
Dissension, that's the problem. We got a problem of getting it all together. But there's still a lot of points to be made up, baby. And I'm sure when it comes down to the $1 million, we're going to have to get it together. Because something's got to happen. Because I want part of that $1 million, baby. You'd be surprised what a guy can do with $1 million, baby. We can dance. We can buy radios. And Johnny Stewart, I know right now you're on my team, baby. But somewhere down the road, I'm going to tear you apart for that light heavyweight champion.
Welcome back to All-Star Wrestling. Today's Team Challenge Series match, Hangman Killer versus Tommy Jammer. Let's go to the ring for more.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next match is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from El Paso, Texas. He weighs in at 275 pounds, and he is one half of the Texas Hangman. He is Hangman Killer.
Big Mo, big motivation. Well, they're going to need it because they are really lacking here. And with only the last 4 weeks, 5 weeks of the Team Challenge Series coming up, some big matches, a lot of points to be made. Zbyszko's going to have to get it going here today with Hangman Killer.
Look at Tommy Jammer get it going right away. He ambushes Hangman Killer, going for a quick pin. Going to work with the arm bar after the beautiful drag takedown.
You know what, Ralph? Looking at these two, I would say this is Psycho in the ring right now.
Yes. I was going to make the point that these two a lot of times do the old switcheroo. And that looks a lot like Psycho.
It definitely does. And it's scheduled to be Killer in the ring. But this doesn't look like Killer. This looks like Psycho. Beautiful move by Tommy Jammer. Fireman Scary. Block those big punches and a beautiful move. You can tell the Baron's been working with Tommy.
Tommy really having things his way. He's only got to fight one of them. He's in good shape. But more often than not, the Hangman find a way to get that second man into the ring.
Did Tommy get a haircut?
Well, it looks like he did.
Oh, beautiful.
One, two. Whoa. Got out of there at two. He is built for speed.
Now, look at it. Let's see if they make a switch here. Now, that is Killer right there. He's the bigger man of the two, and he's scheduled to be wrestling, and that's Psycho that's in the ring. Very confusing for the man wrestling to tell them apart. It's hard to tell for anybody to tell them apart.
Well, the reason, as I say, that looks a lot like Psycho is Killer looks a lot like Psycho. So if Psycho looks a lot like Killer, the converse being true, we can always be messed up. And I think Tommy Jammer's a little bit messed up now as Texas Hangman trying to do a number on him, but Jammer.
Whoa, he's fighting back good. This is the best I've seen Tommy Jammer in a long time. He really is looking good. And look at that physique on
Tommy Jammer. He is quite a specimen. Wrestling for Baron's Blitzers. Standing arm ringer by Jammer. Off of the ropes goes the Texas Hangman. Tommy Jammer waiting.
Abdominal stretch.
Right, the abdominal stretch on. Well, if he locks this one in, that could be all. That was some trouble. And now being distracted by the other angle.
Big forearm to the top of the head and also got him with a knee in the ribs. And that was Hangman's killer, the man who is scheduled to be wrestling.
It's Psycho in there now, we do believe. Hammering Tommy Jammer's head off of the turnbuckle. Now going to work inside with a blow right to the ribs.
It's a good hard-fought match. They're back and forth. They both teams want the points. Tommy Jammer and Baron von Raschke, they could get a big lead here, a bigger lead, widen the gap if they get the points today in this Team Challenge main event.
And the Texas Hangman have really made a history of delivering a lot of pain and sending out a lot of messages and not doing things by the books and hurting their opponents. Tommy Jammer has not backed down one iota. He didn't come into this match scared at all. Oh, that one hurt.
That was close to the throat. If it had been on the throat, the referee could disqualify him.
Now, what's Psycho doing?
No, that's
a killer. What's Killer doing with that rope? You know, they always bring those ropes, those nooses, toward the ring area. Hangman going to work inside on Tommy Jammer. Flying off the ropes, ducks under the clothesline.
Oh.
Flying shoulder tackle, almost had him for the pin.
And listen to this crowd responding to Tommy Jammer. Boy, they like him here.
Watch the throat. At the warning from Selk. Right the forehead and the eyes right over the ropes.
I know it, Baron. That's no bullshit.
Baron von Raschke can only run. That challenge to Tommy Jammer on the receiving end, Greg.
Shut up.
Oh, they're also very vocal. You know, like, they never stop. They never stop yelling at their opponent. They're yelling at the fans. They're yelling at Baron von Raschke.
Yelling at you? There's a belly-to-belly suplex. This could be it for Tommy Jammer. The Hangman's got him in a position where he could pin him. Why he's picking him up, I don't know. He's making a big mistake. Never give your opponent a second chance. Especially a man of the caliber of Tommy Jammer.
Reversal by Jammer.
Come on, Tommy, follow up, baby.
Hangman faltering. Jammer with a drop kick that was a little bit short.
Well, I think he was blinded there by the Hangman. Had got the fingers in the eyes, and he couldn't quite judge that drop kick. Didn't get him where he wanted. A big back body drop. Now Tommy's got it rolling.
Tommy definitely has things going his way. Tried another drop kick. Again, didn't quite miss.
Hey, wait a minute. Ralph, that's the first
they made
man.
The switch.
Now Killer is in the ring. Psycho drop kicked out of the ring. Killer's got Tommy wrapped up in a rolling cradle for the three count.
One, two, three. Look at Baron von Raschke. He's living.
He saw it. Baron saw it. And there was a switch made. That was Killer, who was scheduled to wrestle, had been on the outside the entire match. When the opportunity came up and Psycho was drop kicked out of the ring, Killer rolled in and got the pin on Tommy Jammer. The points will go to Larry's Legend.
Oh, I mean, Larry's Legend needed the points. That gets him to 33, but what a way to make it happen. And now they're going in and trying to ambush the Baron. Jammer going to work on Hangman. Psycho and Hangman Killer getting the worst from Baron von Raschke, who went to the eye guy. Jammer and Baron line them up for a train wreck at center. And Tommy Jammer finishes them off. Baron's forced to claw. But all this means little, as in the face of the adversity, it is the Hangman that gets the point. What a shame.
You know how Baron feels about the Hangman after what happened a few weeks ago here on national TV when they attacked Baron von Raschke, and I'm sure he wants a piece of the Hangman any way he can get him. He doesn't like this decision. Here it is. That is the fresh man. He was not in the ring. The killer who wrapped up Tommy Jammer for the three count.
And the points. Wow, we're coming back with more All-Star Wrestling in just a moment.
Do you need need a car? Listen, each year government agencies auction, sell, and liquidate thousands of cars and trucks, and the bidding starts as low.
Result of today's Team Challenge Series victory by the Texas Hangmen, and I will put it that way. They get 2 points for Larry's Legends, and I guess he needed the points.
Well, he needed the points, but I know Baron von Raschke. You know what happened here a few weeks ago with the Hangmen. He is fired up, and he's already back in the locker room screaming, get me another match with him. Anything, any type of match. Well, next week starts the countdown to the finals for the $1 million in the Team Challenge Series. We're going to hear a lot from Baron von Raschke, hopefully a lot from Sarge's team, and we'll be hearing from the living legend, Larry Zbyszko.
Can anyone catch Baron von Raschke? That question and more will be answered in the weeks to come, so don't you miss it. For Eric Bischoff and my partner, Greg Gagne, I'm ringside Ralph. We'll see you next time on All
Star
Wrestling.